Wonderful. Thank you so much, all of you, for joining us. This is Discussions with the Fashion Masters. My name is Deanna Hansen. I'm a certified athletic therapist and the founder of Fluid Isometrics and Block Therapy. I'm being joined by my nephew and VP of Block Therapy, Quinn Castellane, and our very, very special guest today, Sue Hitzman, founder of the Melt Method. Now, I have been following Sue for years. I remember, Sue, seeing you, I can't remember how many years ago, but on Dr. Oz, and I'm just so excited for anybody that takes the time to truly understand the fascia system, create opportunities for self-care. That's really what we need in this world today, is teaching people how to look after themselves. And I'm just so very pleased that you're here. I just found out it's your 50th birthday on Friday. So
I know.
Another special thing, because Quinn, Sue, and I are all born on the 13th. Like, how exciting. So Sue, take it away. Share your story, how you developed this technique, and yeah. Thanks.
Well, thank you. Yes. Thanks for hanging out with me. I appreciate it. I've been in fitness for 34 years, which is insane. I can't believe 50 is happening. Like what you said, I developed Melt out of my private practice. I was trying to empower my clients to get out of my office faster. And what really got me into fascia was my own chronic pain. I was in fitness for over a decade. And after having a master's in physiology and anatomy and working with sports athletes and all of these other people, getting them out on the field faster, I woke up one day and the bottom of my foot hurt me. And I thought, maybe I stepped on a piece of glass. And that foot pain just was persistent. It didn't go away. And that turned into leg pain and cramping and body-wide fatigue. And it was just, my body started to break down and I started going to doctors and I got CAT scans and they were like, maybe it's lupus, it might be MS, we're not sure. And it was basically, like a lot of people, you just become really frustrated by this idea of pain management, and that just didn't seem right. And seeing my pain started out as plantar fasciitis, I thought, inflamed fascia, can fascia become inflamed, and could that actually be causing me my pain problem? And that sent me down the rabbit hole, because back in the late 90s, that's when Google came out, and the very first word I typed in was fascia, and about 150 sites came up, and I reached out and looked at all of them, and actually a lot of them were about airplane propellers or twigs wrapped in twine. But the ones that were about human fascia, back then you could actually find people's phone numbers on the internet. I mean, it was like massive exposure, right? So I was calling people in Germany and Austria, asking them, like, I read your research paper, can you give me more information about this? And I got into fascial science and research. I met Gil Headley and started doing these layer by layer dissections, which really completely changed how I viewed the human body and connectivity. Became a founding member of the Fascial Research Society. And again, Melt spawned out of my private practice after 9/11, when I was seeing people not because of physical trauma, but emotional trauma. And the same techniques were helping them eliminate their trauma and their pain in their bodies. And I just really started realizing that fascia is a vehicle to better sustainability. It's like going green in your body when you can restore this renewable resource in your body. And then by 2004, I had treated thousands and thousands of people in a private practice. And I thought, gee, maybe I could teach people how to do this in group environments. And so I started developing tools that were soft, that would mimic my hands and my elbow and my forearm. And by 2006, it just exploded. And I started training people in the method. 2010, I started to write the book. And then 2013, my first book came out, it became a New York Times bestseller. Got on to Dr. Oz and Rachel Ray. And today I've got over 2,000 instructors worldwide, 2 books in 28 countries, and just continuing to just try to share the concepts of what causes pain to become chronic and how your brain is producing that sense of pain, and how can we, through the body, mitigate the brain pain game and restore calm in the body through self-care. That's what the Melt Method has really become, is a blends mindful meditation practice with self-care intervention through gentle compression, intentional pull, and breath work to calm the mind and restore joint stability and control.
Wow. It's incredible the parallels that I see in both you and I
think
and
so too.
how we've come to this. And it really did come from that. It's that private practice and wanting, you know, I got to a point where I couldn't see enough patients anymore because people were coming to me and I'm like, wow, like we have to find a way to, you know, so that people don't need individual people. And I remember somebody saying to me a long time ago, you need to clone yourself. So that's, you know, part of how this whole process began for me, because I did try teaching other therapists to do the work, and I have lots of great therapists that can, but again, there's a limit to that. And there's also a really huge expense to that. And for a lot of people, that's not accessible. So to be able to really give people something that they can do at home. And I'm also such an advocate of the daily work, which of course people can't come for daily treatments all the time. So when you're able to do that on a daily basis, it's incredible. Now, one of the things that we see in our community so much is all of the discussions on the emotional release stuff. And, you know, it's really interesting how people are starting to really connect the dots between the fascia and between consciousness. Do you have any amazing experiences you'd love to share with healing crises and things like that?
Oh, I think we all have them. And I mean, I think that you can't really separate the mind and body. I mean, it is one thing. And the interesting thing I always say, you know, if you think about the nervous system, we always want to talk about the brain, but the brain is just a component of the nervous system, albeit a very important part of the nervous system, but the sensory nervous system is living in the fascial continuum. So there's speculation, and you know, you see papers now in journals saying, can fascia hold consciousness? Can it hold memory? Right? And that's a very fine line. One of my teachers, Eric Kandel, had said, you know, the very understanding of consciousness is really going to be the paradigm to fully understand consciousness and cell proliferation. And I do believe that we can create thought viruses and make ourselves sick. And if you have a mysterious pain, like what happened to me, right? I mean, it started out as foot pain, and all of a sudden I just couldn't get out of bed anymore. And then you become frustrated and depressed, and you have anxiety, and it's like you see your world just getting smaller and smaller and smaller, which really unravels people from being in the present moment. So I think the beauty of, you know, your practice, I'm sure, as well as Melt and many others, is that it slows people down. It creates an interruption, and it gets people back into the present moment where transformation can happen. Because transformation cannot happen when you're ruminating in the past or you're fearing your future. So it's when you can bring people back into themselves and slow them down. And I think that that's what I see with my clients, is it's the shift in their mind about their body state that is the doorway into healing, because you're getting your mind to think differently about what is going on. And that's what interoception is, right? Is about my feeling about what I'm feeling, right? It's a secondary step of sensory awareness. And that's what I think Melt really harnesses, is that conscious awareness through the assessment and the evaluation, slowing people down and realizing that most of what's going on in their body is unconscious. It's not in your thinking self that's dictating and making what's happen. And so if you can tap into what we call the autopilot, those parts of our body that support, protect, and stabilize us involuntarily, if you can actively participate in creating efficiency in the autopilot's functions, you can restore calm in your body. And it's a wonderful thing to, you know, just create a daily discipline, like you say, a daily discipline in self-care. Self-care is the best healthcare, for sure. The healthcare industry is not helping people stay well. It's helping people maintain their sickness, really.
That's just so profound and awesome. And I just love how we say the same things, but we come at it from a bit of a different angle. So some people are going to hear it in one way, some people in another way. And the goal is just for everybody to hear it. And one of the things that, you know, we teach a lot is about the pain-fear cycle. So when we're teaching people with block therapy, we teach people to go and seek out the pain. And just as you were saying, like, you know, you're changing that dialogue with yourself. You're actually making pain your friend. So it's no longer something to fear. And then the fear gets taken out of the equation. So pain simply becomes a sensation that gives us information so that we can address whatever it is we need to address. And
yeah, pain's just a great motivator, isn't it? I mean, if anything, pain is really just your brain's way of encouraging you to take action, to pay attention, slow down, and take action. That's really what pain is. So understanding pain is really the first step in resolving it. And that's maybe the difference between our practices also, is what I've learned is when you're in pain, either people just want to tune it out or they're so focused on it that they're just, that's all they can think about. They create, like, it's like their friend, like they talk about it, like they, you know, this thing is there. And what Melt is, again, it's more of an interruption. It's saying, don't pay attention to the pain. I want you to use your body sense. I want you to focus on something beyond your pain. I want you to sense your body in an entirely different way. And that is one of the things that triggers the response in mitigating the pain response that your brain is producing.
Wow. Yeah. Wonderful. That again ties into how we approach things with cause sites and pain sites as well. So we're always teaching people, you know, you don't have to go right to a painful area, because that's simply the result of all the tension the fascia is creating in other areas that are holding. So to be able to connect to a different part of the body and create a release at a distance is also such a nice thing that we get to do with these wonderful tools. Now, so I think you mentioned to me you have about 7 different tools. Can you just share a little bit more about those and how they work through the body?
Yeah, I mean, one of the foundations of the Melt method is actually the hand and foot technique. So, you know, we've got the, you know, like different sized balls, different compression, you know, like to apply to the body. But your hands and feet, there's major receptors in your hands and feet. So I think that the hands and feet are really a missing link in self-care that most people don't focus on at all. And every client that I've ever had with pain, I always start them with either a hand treatment or a foot treatment, depending upon where their pain problem is. And it almost instantaneously starts to change what they're feeling, which is so brilliant. And then we have a whole bunch of different types of rollers. Like our rollers are like soft, they're sort of spongy, they have a rubberized sort of a material to them. And we have a performance roller, which is this one, which is more for my athletes. You know, you can put two together and do the rebalance, but this one is, I kind of think of it as my travel roller. I never leave home without that one. We've got our full roller, we have a half roller, we have resistant bands. My second book over in that corner, Melt Performance, is more about neurological stabilization, so neuromuscular therapy and learning how to reintegrate the timing of stabilization in the shoulder girdle, the pelvic girdle, and the core. So we just kind of, you know, have a variety of different tools so that we can work with anybody. I always say that Melt is really for anyone. It definitely takes a much gentler approach. We instill the indirect before direct approach, just like, you know, you and I with manual therapy. You never go right after the pain source. I think any good therapist will not go right to a pain problem. I always say that's like a kid screaming out for your help and you walking up and punching them in the face. Like that's not how we resolve problems, right? We want to, you know, if a kid was crying out for your help, you'd try to calm them down, you'd inquire, you'd ask questions, you try to really make sense of what was going on, and then you would evaluate and then you would proceed. But when it comes to our bodies, my gosh, if something's screaming out, we're like, you know, jamming balls and rocks in our neck and things like that. And I think that's just it, is that if you go right to the pain source, you could actually increase inflammation, increase, you know, the body's messaging back to the brain that this is bad. And that's just going to further exacerbate your pain. So with all of the tools that we have, you know, with DVDs, we have Melt on Demand. I put out a new video every week so that people can try a different treatment. You know, and it's just tools. I would say like a tool is just a tool. It's the methodology that makes the tools beneficial. So, you know, it's the same thing as with block therapy, right? It's just a block. But if you use it the right way, it can be a magical tool to explore your body in ways that you just wouldn't. And the uniqueness about using tools in general that people should know is, like, when you use your own hands on your body, you're taking information in through the hand receptors and through your skin receptors on the body. So that's really the interesting thing, is if you use a tool, you're helping the body just direct information from one pathway, not two. And that can really also help to trigger an effect of healing, of parasympathetic states.
Wow. Awesome. I love that. You also have a teacher training program. And I remember years ago seeing that you were doing them live, as we were in past. You have an online program now, though?
Yes. I mean, we were partly online anyway. We did a pre-training online to get people prepared for the 5-day live training, and then post-training online. So when COVID happened, you know, there's hundreds of people wanting to get trained, and, you know, you don't want people to lose time in because of something like a virus. So we just quickly pivoted and transformed the trainings, transformed the manuals. And so we have 5 levels of instructor training online that anyone can do anywhere. Our training in January is already, you know, like over 100 people in it. So I'm super excited about walking people through these processes of online education. Which is a trick, right? You know, I mean, when you're trying to do something in a therapeutic way, I think it also empowers our teachers to learn how to use the internet more appropriately. They do classes online. I mean, that's been really the beauty of watching our instructors pivot with us and to say, hey, if you can't teach in a group environment, get online. It's the same thing. And you can still do one-on-one work. You can actually see them very clearly. You know, you can be up close. So I actually think it's created a better educational platform. It's challenged me to put more online, more detail, break it down more clearly. And I think it's helping our instructors move through their education in a better way. It's a little bit more self-paced, and everybody takes information in at their own pace. And I think that that's another great thing about having the online trainings, right? It's great.
Yeah, not to mention you're not limited to your direct community. You can reach people all over the world this way. So that just opens doors for so much more from the perspective of creating a business for yourself.
Indeed.
I have teachers that do both of these modalities together, and they do things together. So I'm just so excited and so thrilled that we had this opportunity to meet. Quinn, do we have any questions from our community for Sue right now?
We got a few comments from the same lady here. Your health is a reflection of your change of mind. Clear the water, get the energy moving again. I do Qigong, if I'm pronouncing that correctly, and block therapy. Qigong, yeah. Right, Qigong.
Yeah.
Meridians and chakras, placebo, nocebo. I cured my lifelong fibromyalgia, arthritis, and asthma off 20 pharmaceuticals. I believe I was sick. It was the shift of consciousness within the allowed 70 pounds to just melt off my body. I now teach Qigong. It all works if you believe. And then she mentioned pain tells you what to work on. So that's super cool, because I also really appreciate how you mentioned, Sue, so much of it is about the mind and what you believe. And again, that can tie into the placebo, because I'm a big fan and advocate of Dr. Joe Dispenza, and I follow like a lot of his meditations, and the combination, holy smokes, of working on your fascia system and connecting the mind to it and just changing your whole belief system and your patterns of thinking. He calls it rewiring the brain. That has been some of the biggest changes in my physical and mental health, 100%. So I think this lady proved that for herself as well. And it's just cool how we can combine these different modalities together to make an ultimate form of self-healing and self-care. So I think that's
our
intentions.
Yeah, well, and that's just it, is there's no one diet. There's no one methodology that's going to heal your problems, right? I just think that's not true. What I think all of us, and this is like, you know, the like-minded educators in our field, Jill Miller, Yamuna, Deanna, right? You know, I mean, all of us are really out to just share the information in the way that we've taken it in and to share it. But when people say, oh, well, isn't she a competitor? I'm like, well, I guess a competitor in product sales, but she's a colleague who's trying to bring wellness and betterment to the body. So, you know, I always say, if one thing doesn't work, don't scrap it. try something else. And then what did you learn here that seemed to be something that you could really resonate with, and start to infuse pieces together? I mean, for melt, I always say, if you melt for 10 minutes, like melt your feet and then do your Qigong, and you will feel something different, right? With Deanna's work, with working on the abdomen, right? If you did like an upper back rehydrate and a neck release and then worked on your abdomen, you might fly to the moon. I don't know, right? You know what I mean? But you would find, if you give yourself permission to go into your body and sense what you feel in a new way, and then you touch yourself. I think we need to touch. We need to, feel ourselves in different ways, because this is how you continue to challenge these sensory receptors, so that these neurons that fire together and wire together, we might find that we have some poor pathways. And if you start to send information into the body in a new way, that can create synaptic pruning in bad pathways and start to daisy chain new pathways. So I think that there's always a complementary approach in a multifaceted, multidisciplinary, multimodality way where you can care for yourself. You know, again, I'm 50 in 2 days here. Good God, 3 days. And my, when somebody says, well, what's your secret? I'm like, well, I can give you a list of what I think is like, what things have I done in my lifetime that I think have helped me to age better and transform myself over the past 30 years from going from, from 20 years ago having terrible pain to coming back to a place where I get up out of bed, I don't feel achy or stiff. I feel good all the time. And I know that, I could list a pile of things that make that happen. It's not just melt. I think it's a mindset, mindful meditation. I'm out in nature all the time. I do earthing, and I try everybody's modalities, because I think that this is how you learn who your allies are and who to connect with and who's authentically giving information out that is something that somebody should try, and that's, I think, what we're here to do. It's, I'm not telling somebody, only do melt. Like, it's like, that's crazy. Try everything until you find what works. And when it resonates with you, stick with that. But just remember, keep trying more things, because that's where plateaus happen, is when you keep doing the same thing over and over, right? And you expect changes. That's insanity, right? You gotta keep trying different things, and that's what transforms your body.
And that's something that we also teach and preach a lot too, is if somebody comes in and they are suffering with chronic pain, or they're wanting to rid their cellulite, or whatever the case really is, if they're doing other modalities, they're seeing a chiropractor, they're going to a physio, they might ask, do I have to stop these things before attempting or trying block therapy? Absolutely not. You can, again, block therapy is a complement to other modalities. The melt method, it's all a complement. And then just like, as you mentioned, you can wean through and see what you like and go from there. Keep testing things out. I had to do that. I think people have to do that with nutrition. That's becoming more prevalent today too. This food is amazing for you, but it's toxic for this person. So
that's right. That's a big one, right? Just because a diet they say is a healthy diet, it may be, but it may not be a healthy diet for you. Like, maybe your liver has a hard time assimilating mercury. So even though a pescatarian diet is great for one person, it might not be great for you. So that's, again, it's life is a journey, right? It's the exploration today that gets us into tomorrow. Don't worry so much about tomorrow. Don't sweat the small stuff, and don't ruminate in the past. Reflect on it, learn from it, and then stay right here, because that's where transformation happens.
100%. Absolutely.
Excellent. Quinn, any other last comments before we get Sue's last comment and wish her a happy, happy 50th? I can't believe, Sue, you're turning 50.
I know it.
I can't believe that. I can't believe that you're both 50 and you don't look a day over 35.
Thanks. You know what? But that's it. I think that we practice what we preach, right? I think 100%. That when you've had the struggle and you realize what it is, it's like, well, I always say, if ever I question my birthright, I'm never going to do that again. And I know what it feels like and what got me into those pain things, and I'll never do that again either. You know, like, you just learn. That's what was right. If you take the emotion out of a memory, you got wisdom, right? I think Joe Dispenza, that might be a Joe Dispenza quote. But that's it, is, your past gives you wisdom, and it allows you to really find your joy today and really stay with what's happening now. One of the things I say to myself quite frequently, if I'm, something's bothering me, is I stop and I say, Sue, what's your problem right now? I was like, I don't really have a freaking problem. It's like, well, then stay right there. Stop going over there. Just stay right here. Do you have a problem or not? I don't. Stay there.
Awesome. I love that self-talk. I catch myself saying sometimes the craziest things to myself, but
I think we all do.
Yeah.
I'm just going to read off.
You have 38,000 conversations in a day and 37,992 are with yourself.
That's exactly it.
That is so true, especially now. Hey,
no kidding.
Okay. So I'm going to read off a few comments here. Lynn Marie, who I read off earlier, she was referring to Bruce Lipton, but I know Bruce Lipton and Joe Dispenza do a lot of work together, but that's amazing. They both teach and preach.
I love Bruce.
And Bruce has been around for a really long time too. So Deanna, we were actually supposed to see Joe Dispenza and Bruce Lipton this month.
Last month. Yeah.
Unfortunately, that got canceled, but
we were planning really on going to Hawaii and spending some days there, but sometime.
It'll happen. We'll all come back into groups. That's what I always say is we'll all come back into groups. Don't worry too much about that. Right now, just take care of your health. Do things that, you know, eat water-filled foods, you know, sip water frequently, find joy every day, find your happiness and stay healthy. Just do it right now. Don't worry too much about that future.
Absolutely. All right. So here's another comment. Really thankful to hear this. I went from 5 pills every morning to none with diet and mind training. I also do Qigong.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to ask you guys every single time just in case. But being familiar with the vagus nerve is key. Absolutely. That does play a massive role, especially when it taps into the parasympathetic nervous system and state. Okay. I am a neurofascial therapist in Powell Springs in San Diego, and I'm a big promoted for the MELF method by my patients. Awesome. So patients are telling her about the MELF method. Awesome. Sorry, the words are really tiny on my screen. So if I take a while to read these, I apologize. I like this. Product sales are not competition. They're or collaboration with the right attitude and people. You can't build a house with just a hammer. You need all the tools. I really appreciate that comment actually. That's because I absolutely agree. And again, like this conversation and just to share that we're working on the fascia system from slightly different approaches. It's like, try them together. This could be an absolute game changer for many, many people. Okay. So many great tools. Thank you for introducing me to more self-care options. Love it. So that's all of the comments for now and the questions, but
okay. Yeah. Well, Sue, again, thank you so much for joining us. This has been such a revolutionary conversation for so many people in our community to really hear and learn from the founder what your technique is all about. And if you have any last things to share.
Well, I would just say, you know, to everybody, if you feel like your body's struggling, if you feel like, you know, you are stuck. Stuck is your body just gagging to express itself. That's all it is. So allow that voice to be heard inside of you. Listen to those messages and just do your best to just stay positive and seek out people that will help you, because there is a brilliant community out there. And, you know, just keep going. Keep going.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.
Thanks so much for having me.
And have a glass of champagne on me.
I will. And a little bit of gluten-free carrot cake from my friend Jackie. I can't wait.
Oh, it sounds delicious.
Awesome. Well, so that will wrap up the discussions with the Fashion Masters. Thank you so much, Sue, for joining. This has been so awesome to communicate with you and just get to know you a little bit better. And to see all these people starting to collab both and just improving their health. That is our intention. Our intention is to help and to heal. And I think by tapping into the fascia system, that is a major, major key and discovery. So that is everything. Thank you guys so much for joining. This discussion will be on our YouTube channel. So just give that a few days and have an awesome rest of your day. And Sue, happy birthday in 3 days.
Thank you.
Have the
Thank
best
you very
time.
Much. Thank you.
And that's everything. Have an awesome day.
Bye, everyone. Bye.